Automatic settings within Final Cut, an awesome feature, but sometimes you want to override them. Let's learn all about them right over here. First, let's create a new project by using the shortcut Command-N. The new project window will pop up in the top center of the screen. Modify these first three settings as needed. By default, Final Cut Pro uses automatic settings. This means that your project settings will be based on the first clip that you add. We'll show you what this means. Here, we have a sample project created with automatic settings. If we drag a clip into our project settings will automatically match this clip's settings. The inspector on the top right corner of this screen will display the clip's properties. Make sure that your inspector panel is open by toggling this icon. Then select the Information tab by choosing the icon with the lowercase I. We can see here that the clip's resolution is 1920 by 1080, and its frame rate is 29.97 frames per second. Then, if we check the project settings, they will match the clip's properties exactly.
Piece of cake.
In some cases, your clip may not match any of the built-in presets for Final Cut Pro. When this occurs, this window will pop up in the top center of your screen. This means that although the project settings will be based on the clip, certain settings were adjusted. In this example, the color space was changed to fit Final Cut Pro's standard settings. If you're okay with this, click the button to accept. And that's that. If you'd rather your project properties match the clip exactly, locate the custom setting inside the video format dropdown. By choosing custom, it preserves the color space adapted from the clip as Rec. 601. Intermission. Let's get back to work. Let's check out how to modify your settings. In the browser, select the project you want to modify by double-clicking it. Make sure that your properties inspector is visible by toggling this icon on the top right. Now click Modify. The Modify Settings window will appear in the center of your screen. Now you can modify the settings to anything you want.
If you feel like we're moving a little bit too quickly, just take a deep breath, step back, and come back when you're ready.
Now let's dive into the project settings and see how they all work. Project name, of course, is where you can type the name of your project. You can change the name at any time. The event dropdown is where you can choose the event to store your project. Starting time code allows you to determine what time code your project will start on, but you can probably leave it at zero for the most part. Drop frame is an option that appears when you have a frame rate of 29.97 or 59.94 selected. For the most part, you can leave this unchecked. This video section has several options for changing your project's video format, resolution, and frame rate. You can change the video format according to the needs of your project. For example, 1080p is a pretty standard choice for a good quality YouTube video. Resolution is the size of your frame in pixels. It's generally a 16 by 9 ratio. Like how this 1080p format generates a resolution of 1920 by 1080 pixels. Frame rate, also known as frames per second, determines how many frames are shown in 1 second of footage. In the rendering section, you can choose which codec you want to use for your project's background rendering. You can also see the designated color space for your project. In case you need to change it, go back to the Format dropdown and choose Custom. These are the standard color spaces you can choose from. But generally, you should keep the color space standard to the video format you've chosen.
And we're not done yet.
Now let's check out the audio section. For channels, you can choose to present the audio as surround sound or as stereo. And for your sample rate, a smaller sample rate generally produces lower quality audio with the advantage of smaller file sizes. On the other hand, a large sample rate will produce higher quality audio with larger file sizes. Once you have your settings chosen, click OK to confirm.
And that's it. That's how you modify your project settings.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
If you'd like to see the next episode in this series, or the past one, or the future one, and